The whole thing about the Chef of the Year was obviously introduced to try and give back to the industry.
So since the beginning, since we started doing Koti, we were very connected to the chefs. We didn't start this because of pure marketing thing. We started it from chefs to chefs.
Many, many greats have entered the competition, won it as well. A couple of them that I can mention is Bill Gallagher, Hans Bruno, Glenn Sinclair, Garth Strubel, Garth Schneer. It's endless, Gerard van Staden, etc.
If I look back of the Chef of the Year, it's amazing the type of chefs that have won, who've become amazingly high profile, leading chefs today in all walks of the industry.
It originally started at Hudson & Knight competition, and then it moved from there. It went on to Marvello Chef of the Year, and then obviously we changed it to the Unilever Food Solutions Chef of the Year.
The Marvello Master Chef of the Year was the event on the culinary calendar.
It was a very important competition, and it was the competition that launched my career, actually.
We had just immigrated, been in the country 5 months, and I received notification I had won this prize. And I remember being presented with a check and the following morning going to the hospital in Port Elizabeth to give it to the hospital. My son was born 2 days before. So we say that that money came in really handy.
I do remember the day very, very well. I'd flown in and got up early in the morning, just quickly rechecked the knives, made sure the uniform was, you know, in really sparkling condition, because you want to feel good when you go into the kitchen. You want to feel like a winner before you walk in.
I won it in 2002, which was the first time. It was just after my 21st birthday, the actual final. Then I won again in 2004, and then again a team of four in 2009.
When I started off, or when I did the competition, I was scared. I was always thought, okay, I'm just a normal chef. And after winning this, it gave me the self-confidence to be better, greater, always trying new things.
I think as a young chef, winning a competition like Unilever Chef of the Year, it kind of gives you the opportunity to be recognized by some of the best chefs in South Africa, and I think all around the world even.
Unilever has always been up there as one of the best competitions that you participate in, and you know, once you win a Unilever Chef of the Year, then you really are at the top of your game.
If you're in Chef of the Year, you can become part of something great. I think I'm looking at Petrus, a guy that's won it before. He started as a pot washer, and it just tells you, and now he's in Braai Master, he's one of the judges. He's in a 5 Michelin star at the moment.
A lot of the preparation for competition is actually mentally. And physically, you should be able to do it by then you've practiced, and it's just on the day. It's holding your nerve, keeping calm.
The value of competition is immense. It teaches you discipline, timing, that you have to practice, but really practice. Gives you the opportunity to be innovative, creative, panic a little. I think it's something we should encourage.
A lot of even people at that stage offered new jobs the same day. So, you know, you walk in and they greet you and say, listen, okay, we're willing to take over your position, where you're working, come and see us, interviews straight away.
It really has helped me grow my career and put me off on the right step.
It evolves every single year. We try and add new dimensions, new categories to it. You've got press that is flying in. I mean, the logistics behind that is unbelievable. So the money that we spent behind this competition last year was about R1 million. We're looking at about 60 contestants, where when it comes to that, we're one of the biggest competitions in the country, and it's very hard to try and match or try and keep up with our standards.
The comments we got from the judge was that it's an exciting moment for them because they can see what is happening in South Africa. They know the best talents will come for Chef of the Year. So they want to be here. They won the competition in the past. Now they're judging. And even if they're not judging, we've got some chefs that just want to be here. So everybody's connected. That's the moment where we as a company are connected to chefs and to the industry, to the food, to the things that we love. And for me, that's the best out of Chef of the Year. And that will be there for many, many years.
I think Unilever have taken a concept and really made it into the Oscars for chefs. We wouldn't have had that.
Well, these guys have been phenomenal throughout the years, always promoting the chef's industry, sponsoring, coming up with innovative ideas, competitions, products that, you know, they've done a huge amount for the industry over the years.
You know, I thank Unilever for everything that they've done for me in my career because of this competition, because it's put me on the platform and given me the opportunities to do what I've done and get to where I've got now.
The whole competition then basically just gave me, it was a little bit of a vehicle to show me what other people are doing and how to adjust my own cooking skills to what's going on out there.
Entering professional chefs competitions is, I think, a great gateway to self-promote yourself. Gives you an opportunity to network with your colleagues and peers in the industry, share ideas, and look out for new trends.
2015, we have Wax that will endorse Chef of the Year. We're extremely excited. This will mean that we'll have an international judge from overseas, obviously, yeah, to oversee the whole thing.
And it is great, you know, to have this partnership. That means we are the best in the world. So in the past, we would say we are the best in South Africa. Now we can say we are the best in the world because of that. Yeah.
One thing I would like to say is Unilever played their part in developing SA chefs. If I look back, the investment, not only in cash, but the faith you've had in us, all the Olympic teams, you guys should take a bow also.